What's up, everyone? As promised, I'm going live. Let's see who will join. Hey, what's up? Great, people start joining. So as I was informing that this live is gonna be Q&A session, you can ask me any question regarding motivation or e-commerce, and I will do my best to provide you more open answers. Hey bro, welcome. So any kind of question regarding e-commerce, Facebook ads, Shopify settings, or motivation, how to change your things, your life, and your skills, and improve your any kind of skills, just let me know and I will try to give you open answer. Okay, first question is here, perfect. How much do we start for dropshipping at start? What do you mean? Do you mean the budget? I would not suggest to go in any kind of dropshipping or e-commerce business without at least $1,000 or $1,500, at least. Because that is really important to have a backup with you. Very important. When you start testing ads, you will have a lot of products which is gonna be not working. And each product to test, you need at least 70 to 120 bucks. It depends on the performance. If product gonna be performed and give you some sales, you will be seeing some, if you, it will give you some sales and give you potential, so you will be testing and spend a bit more. And each product you have to test and spend approximately $100. Usually, as per the practice, to find the winner, you need to test 5 to 12 items in general. Sometimes more, sometimes less. So I have a couple of students who have found the winners from first testing. That is insane. It's really super, super rare, but it happens. When it's first or second product, it's a winner. So, but in that case, you don't need $1,000 with you. But that is super rare happens. Most of the time, you need the budget when you start running ads. As a platform, of course. It can be any kind of platform where you can build a website. Shopify is just the most loud name on the market and the most converting platform, where its conversion rate is really great. That's why Shopify was created for the dropshipping, not the dropshipping, it was created for the brands, for e-commerce business. And conversion rate there is most highest. And plus another one is ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels, if you have already winner, you can make a brand, and if it's you wanna make one product store. Better doing not on Shopify one product store, make it on the ClickFunnels, because there is conversion rate instead of 3.5-4% as on Shopify. In ClickFunnels it's gonna be around 6-8% conversion rate, which is awesome. What is your step-by-step algorithm to finding winning product? So first of all, everything not about the Facebook, like if it's question about algorithm, first of all it's about the setup your store and set up your product page, and actually the main point is set up your store. Second point, research the product and make the only unique and really some products which is gonna be super helpful for the people, and maybe which will gonna be catch your eye. Not maybe, it's for sure. They're supposed to catch your eye, because now so many products on the market, you're supposed to give potential buyers some kind of hook. When they scrolling in the newsfeed, they're supposed to see something interesting to stop. So some kind of hook this product must have, and your message for that product. And before preparing any kind of ads, there is 5 steps set up from my end, what we are always following with my students, with my agency, before running ads. First of all, store setup. Secondly, product research by the criteria which we are personally using only. Third one, it's product description. Without proper description, you should not run ads. So many people who are not aware about that, they are just copied description from the AliExpress through Obro, and that's all. And this is completely bullshit, because no trust to the store and people won't buy it. Only if it's super hot product, in that case I have seen that people had results with bullshit description. So step number three, it's product description. Step number four, it is video. Video is supposed to be unique. You should not use video from other people. If you want advertise with video ad, just take 3-4 videos from different suppliers, 3-4 videos from the ads on the market, and just edit them and make one or two unique one. Okay, so build some unique video, create that video, and after that just go to Facebook. And step number five, it's gonna be ad copy. It must be strong ad copy. Usually we are testing 3 different copies, okay, or 3 different videos, or 2 different videos, 1 photo in one ad set, and different approach. So one ad copy must be with emoji, standard one, what dropshipping are using, so emoji, one sentence about the product, how cool is that and why you should buy that. The most important, people are not using the exact reason why your buyer supposed to buy this product, okay, and supposed to click on the link. You should give them you have to give them a reason why they're supposed to buy. And for example, it's pain relief product. You're supposed to tell them how their life gonna be changed if they started using that product. They will feel better, they can accomplish more goals, they can enjoy with their family more, because they forget about the headache, they forget about the back and the pain in the back, whatever. So you're supposed to give them reason to click on the link. And this is like ad number two, ad number one, with emojis, some reason to click on the link, and bullet points. This is standard ad copy. Another one we are using, as most of the brands, big brands, using just short one sentence. Again, the most strong bullet point on ad copy, the most one. Without emoji, just clean sentence about the product. And third one, it's most of the time is just mix of the first and second, a bit of emojis, and more text about the product without bullet points. So it's gonna be inside of the sentences, the bullet points. When to start using conversion objection on the Facebook ads? Good question. If you have completely new ad account, I suggest you to go with engagement, post-engagement objection, for at least 30 bucks at least, okay? Just to warm up a bit your ad account. After that, if you go to conversion, you have to spend around 30 to 50 bucks a day for next couple of days. Because Facebook don't like people who jump in on ads and start investing shit of money on the new, completely virgin ad account, because it's gonna be disabled. Even if it's not tomorrow, you start getting results, it will be disabled in 2 weeks from that. Because Facebook machine knows when someone just start throwing money on the ads, they don't like it, because most of the scammers are doing that. So Facebook trying to protect that. That's why first couple of days you must be super, super careful and go super slow. That even if you have already proven winner, just $50 a day for a couple of days, $100 a day for a couple of days, $150, and slowly, 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 you're gonna be increasing your ad spend for $1,000, $1,500, up to $5,000, where is the limit usually on the Facebook ad accounts, and until you will be request for the increasing limit. Okay? Okay, what is next? Step-by-step algorithms of product research. So first of all, I will be honest with everyone, we are trying to find only high tickets, okay? So we are not focusing on low tickets at all. I will give you the reason, an example actually. On June last year, we decided to test low tickets, because before that we were long time on the fashion niche. Watches, shoes, belts, and so on. So, and it was medium margin, like 40, 50 bucks on each product. which we were having. But we had so many surrounding people who were speaking about the great results with low ticket, which we never test. So we decided to jump there, and in 1 week we have made $11,000 in sales, which is not bad. Like, even it's good, because we start testing and from day one we start scaling that. So $11,000 in sales in 7 days, but it was so many orders because item was $14, only $40 item. And because of that, you can imagine, you can calculate, it was more than $800 products sold, more than 800 in 1 week. And our VAs, virtual assistant team, if we would not have them, it would be fucked up. So our virtual assistants were really super, super busy with fulfillment, with customer service, with everything. And at the end, we calculate we made only a couple of $100 profit from 11K. It was insane. It was like, and we are good with upsells and cross-sells. So our average ticket price is 14. Average ticket was 47, 57. So we were sold well with upsells, with everything. But margin was so thin that keep the profit and scaling fast, it wasn't possible. So that's why I highly suggest you, in our days, Facebook is super expensive. Do not jump on Facebook with low tickets. Someone is super successful on it, and I don't mind, but super successful, like, as I said, $2-3 and you make 3,000 orders a day. Okay, perfect. But you can calculate, it's nothing of it. Like, profit is super low. And it's just insane. I'm going with the products which is having at least 40, let's say 30, it's minimum in my opinion, 30 to 70 or even $90 margin. And that is giving you rights to jump directly when you find potential winner, jump directly on the profit road when you just start your Facebook ads. So first of all, margin is supposed to be high, and especially high, at least 30 plus. In our days, everything below 20, it's completely disaster to be managed. We have one store, actually a successful store, who is already made with us 5,000 this month. And profit, product margin there is only 22 or 24. When he joined, he was on $12 margin. I was shocked, like $12, it's like, it's not, it's insane. And he was still like small profit, he was profitable because he made it only $70 a day, so a couple of sales a day. So we just joined it, we changed the prices for this product, and we just start scaling that slowly, because still 22 is super low. And slowly we are still profitable. We are still profitable till the end. We have good profit, around 25 to 27% profit, because again, we have upsells, people buying a couple of products. Hey Ross, what's up, my man? So people are buying a couple of products at the same time, and because of that, we are fine, actually, with that kind of margin. But at the end, I highly recommend not go lower than $30 margin, okay? So about the product research, we are going on the different websites like Amazon, AliExpress. We are going on the American huge branded stores, which is as well having China's product, but it's already branded. We are going through different websites, not dropshipping websites, brands, and seeing some kind of awesome products. And after that, we research by the keywords in AliExpress if we have that kind of product in AliExpress. Plus, we have different suppliers who can supply outside of AliExpress. I mean, if that product is not available on AliExpress, we can ask them to find it in the China's website, like Tmall, 1688. And others dropshipping websites in the Alibaba in the China market. Hey, Brandon, thanks, I appreciate it, man, my man, thank you. He's working with us on our ads agency. Thanks, man. As I just was speaking about your product, like about the low margin, that when you join, you have a small margin, now we increased, and slowly we are still profitable. Just confirm that if I'm correct. Because this person, he is here live and he can tell about it. Okay. Product research. We are doing, first of all, items which has good margin. Secondly, we are researching from different websites for eye-catching products. And third one, we are using something. We are looking for something which is nobody selling. Because everyone following, all dropshippers following each other to steal the products. Oh, he has a winner in the store, let's take it. He has another winner in the store, let's take it. And because of that, everyone having only two ROAS, if they're gonna be lucky to get a winner from that winning product what they saw in another store, everyone start jumping there and Facebook doesn't like that. And if a couple of them get luck, they take 2-2.5 ROAS, return of ad spend only. But when you sell the product which is other people are not selling, your return of investment 4, 5, 7 plus ROAS. Sounds good for that for you? I believe so. Okay, so I will return to other questions because I didn't complete this product research. So we are looking for products which nobody is selling. So if you look in AliExpress, products which are sold 5,000 orders. So in our end, we are looking for some products which is sold only a couple of hundred times from different suppliers. Less than 1,000, I would say. And those kind of products, usually nobody even searching. I mean, they're on the page number 8, page number 12. People are lazy, don't go there. They don't go there when they're searching some kind of niche. And we are doing that. We are searching in different websites after that by using keywords. We are finding some products which is nobody even thinking about. And it is super hard to find a winner there. Super hard. All my students know that who are already working in this system, that it's supposed to be tested. But when you found it, like for example, by my strategy, Mark was using one of my students. In October, he has made from first month $38,000 in sales. And December to January, he was made it already more than $50,000 in 1 month. So this is the power of that kind of products. Nobody's selling. We're still searching. It's still not saturated, that kind of product. Because nobody knows about it. You know, of course, people will start make attention and double check if there is kind of possibilities to steal that. But it's going to be only a couple of hundred people instead of 1,000 who are following this kind of mass products which is everyone selling. Plus, we never use this kind of apps like AliShark or something similar where someone giving you potential products which is everyone selling. Again, because most lazy people are doing that. And most lazy people getting the same results. Or no results, or low profit, or a lot of sales, but no profit because they don't know how to scale that because they were lazy. And they were thinking that if they watch a couple of videos, they just knows everything about the Facebook algorithms. But unfortunately, no, it doesn't work that way. So we are looking for the unique products, which nobody is selling with good margin, searching in different websites, even China market website, asking our suppliers if we cannot find it in AliExpress. Even now we are start looking on the products which we can create by ourselves and make a deal with manufacturer. There is several ways to make a deal with the manufacturer and ask them for customized product, which is not exist on the market. They can write design for you. They can write whatever you want. I mean, if you will sign up for their service, you can make a deal with them for super great deal where they in a couple of weeks will prepare for your design and create the product. There is a couple of the websites who can do that in the China market. But we haven't done that yet, but we are planning because this is really an amazing opportunity to sell something what is nobody selling. So that one, it's the main criteria. You have just to make more... Hey, what's up, Noah? Nice to meet you here. So that is the most important, to have proper product research. And you have to go out of the box. You should not follow the people who are selling other potential winners. Of course, if you see the product which is super hot, you have to try it. If you have good margin and it has good margin and it's super hot on the market, you can try it if you have budget. Of course, you can do that because sometimes we get this kind of winners. But these kind of winners, they are dying fast. Winners can die. And if it's super hot on the market and all the people are selling that, most probably soon this product gonna be die. So you have to scale that super fast, or you have just to get some kind of money for the future testing. So take the profit and don't spend it. Leave it for the future testing of different products and go back to your unique product research. Otherwise, it's gonna be like a rate race, seriously. If you follow only the dropshippers who are selling mass products, you won't stay long because it's burning out fast and you will not even recognize when your profit became your loss, and you will be like, you're gonna be mess. So please follow product research only by the unique products and which is catch the eye, and use the websites, all the websites around except AliExpress. In AliExpress, you're gonna be only looking for suppliers from the beginning. But when you find in Amazon some branded product, in another websites, even in Europe, some branded product, you can find it in AliExpress easily because everything is copied. Don't look on AliExpress as a main source. Let's see, I have seen some questions there. Thanks, Ross. Appreciate for your words. Mas, thank you. You use Niche Scrapper for research for survive service, like? No, Niche Scrapper, I'm using Niche Scrapper, but not to research the products. Actually, Niche Scrapper is really awesome tool. First, like analytics about the AliExpress, I'm not really believing about that, but okay, let's say analytics is correct there, but I never look on it because, again, products which I'm searching, nobody is selling. So analytics of how hot that product right now, which is showing a Niche Scrapper, for me is not important. For me, important in Niche Scrapper that you can find the store where is already this product exists, who already made proper description there, you can find it, and there is by one button press, you can copy it, hold the description. But I would never, ever, ever use other product description because again, Facebook knows everything. Facebook machine can analyze that you copied from somewhere. So what I would do and why I'm using Niche Scrapper, I'm just press copied. It copied description with all GIF format pictures, with all videos, with everything what I need. And after that, I'm just changing description in my way. Around 40 to 50% I make the changes. And instead of taking a couple of hours, or for a person who doesn't have any experience, couple of days, sometimes my students take it, it's even week to prepare one simple product page. It will take 15 minutes, maybe 1 hour. So product description is ready. You need just to swipe, to change the pictures, add something from your opinion, add some bullet points, done. That's why Niche Scrapper is an amazing tool, as for me. This is how I'm using mostly Niche Scrapper. And plus, as I said, there is like, I'm just sometimes scrolling to see maybe something is gonna be showing on the top. But even I'm going through old winners, which was last year, to see what was selling before, maybe I missed something. Only that this reason I'm using Niche Scrapper. Where can I get a person who can make me a genuine dropshipping winning store? Do you mean developers? There is several developers who are not charging a lot. Actually, in our end, we have a developer who is just charging like 300 or something like that, when other development company charging around $1,000, $1,500, $5,000 even. It's insane. But still, people are paying that price. But at the end, first of all, you can do really nice store by yourself. Just spend a bit time to study this Shopify, it's drag and drop store. It's super easy to create. And secondly, you can ask some developers, like as I said, in our end, if you need the store, I'll ask our developer to make it. It's no interest in my end, nothing. It costs around $300 or $400. I'll ask the developer, I will connect you, done. And you can make a deal with him. And that's all. So this is, and it takes usually to create the website like 2 days. If we order a website from them, it is 2 days. It's completely set up, even around 25 to 30 products, general products is already there. Okay. Any questions from you, your side, guys? Any more questions? Maybe I missed something. Okay, how much profit we get at least on single product? So, good question actually, because nobody's speaking about the profit. And this is insane, because profit is everything. Why we jumping in e-commerce, in any kind of opportunities, correct? And nobody speak about that. Everyone's speaking, oh, the revenue, 100,000, 200,000, 10,000, 1,000. And people are like, wow, that guy, I made more than 2 million in total, 2 million in sales. It doesn't mean that I'm a millionaire. No, it means I'm earning good money, good enough money. But 2 million is revenue. And profit is usually, if everything is in proper way with the profit proper margin, from 18 to 24%. But if it's super hot product, it can be like in one student store, it was 35-50% profit. It was insane. This is, I have seen one time in my life that it was over 40% most of the time profit, daily basis. So this kind of stuff, it happens with when you have good margin, good upsells, and in that case, it's really going super high profit. But usually, if you see some revenue and person knows what he's doing, it will be a profitability around 18 to 22%, sometimes 24, which is most of the time in our case, because we are going with the high ticket, we have 24 to 30%, but at the end of the month, with all fluctuation, it's going around 24. But with medium tickets, I would say 18 to 22 for sure. Like if it's great upsells, it can be 22, 24. But to, as I said, there is like weeks with 30%, can be weeks with 18 or 20. It depends how hard you're scaling, how big your profit margin, how good your upsell, cross-sell setup, and how hard you're scaling. If you're scaling super hard, you can burn all your profit. That's why we prefer day by day, smooth and steady. Day by day, one ad set, another ad set, slowly, slowly. After that, when you're already in week or 10 days or 2 weeks, it depends on performance, we see great results. And consistency is the key. If you see consistency, you start scaling that. And that's all. This is the most important. Just don't rush. Because first of all, when people see some first sales, they start rush and they burning out the algorithm and done. Nothing is there, so product is burning, nothing is going well, they cannot scale it, and they lose the money. Even in first days, they got, let's say, $20, $30, $50, $100 profit, and after that, they decide just to increase the budget. It doesn't work like that, guys. It doesn't work like that. Don't do that. Never just increase the budget, okay? There is step-by-step system which you have to follow if you want to make proper sales and profit on your store. Otherwise, you just burn all your profit, you'll make huge loss, and you can, because of that, give up on the e-commerce. And you say, it doesn't work for me. It doesn't work for you, just if you don't know what to do. Think about that, okay? Do you use PayPal or Stripe? Yeah, so PayPal or Stripe. Stripe is the best for me. Even better than Shopify payments. It's as for me. But PayPal is must, because when we remove PayPal from the store, conversion rate is really reducing a lot. Like, it sometimes drop down to 70% in sales. It's really insane. So that's why I would say you need both. I have a six-figure students who are using only Stripe, but I don't have six-figure students who used only PayPal. PayPal is receiving credit card payments, but it's transferring to PayPal website, which is reduced the conversion. People are leaving when it's giving them another website. But Stripe, you just type your credit cards, purchase, done. So that's why Stripe is much better for conversion. PayPal, more people are using. But if only PayPal, your conversion rate is gonna be shit. But if PayPal and Stripe, your conversion rate is going to be like in perfect space. When you remove PayPal, leave it only Stripe, you can survive. When you remove Stripe and leave it only PayPal, most of the time, it's going to be difficult to survive. Or you going to be creating the code. You can do that. You can speak to PayPal support. Where is that code? It will create the button on your landing page, which is going to be giving them option to type credit card information on the order page and without transferring to PayPal website. And that one is going to be solution for you to using only PayPal. As for me, it's only the solution. This I advertise, I don't get orders. The time I don't advertise, I get orders. Yeah, it happens a lot when you don't have a winner. But like, look, if you have orders from item which you are not advertising and it's organically coming all the time from the same item, This is the sign from Facebook and from a Shopify algorithm. This is the potential winner. Look on me, look on me. I'm a winner. Advertise me. Test it. If something what you advertise and you off the ads and later on you have some sales, sometimes Facebook tracking, giving the people, they log in to your website, they just landing on your website, they leaving website because someone just called them, they were next to McDonald's state and they were just ordering McDonald's. After that they received the food and they turn off mobile while they were in the queue, they just was in your website trying to shopping, and after that they got the food and they just switch off the mobile. So in a couple of days they go in browser, oh really, this kind of product I was planning to buy, and they're buying. Okay, and it could be not tracking by Facebook, it could be just like organic sale. It happens in different ways, but what I'm trying to say, if it's the same product what was running before, but you turn it off and start getting sales like in a week after, it is most probably like those people who left your website without buying. So I hope that makes sense. But of course, organic sales as well can come, but just organic, when your store brand new, almost not possible. It is like, there is some reason for that. There is some reason. But if there is like hot product, like my first winner, I was spent more than $4,000, even I don't remember exactly, but it was $4,000 to $6,000 on ads, on testing, when I didn't know what I am doing, and I have zero results, had zero, I was about to give up. And it was always organic sales by one t-shirt. It was like cat t-shirt with the pocket on the chest. And when you remove the pocket, there is like outside of the pocket kitty, like small kitten. You just remove it and it's showing fuck. It's super fun. Ladies 45 plus was going crazy on it when you remove the pocket on the photo and there is fuck of the, from the kitten. It was like super, like people were laughing and buying as crazy. Even five people at the same time were buying. So what I'm trying to say, I didn't make attention on this t-shirt. It was always selling organically, and I was pushing socks, I was pushing some kind of different stuff, which was cheap, which was like $9, $5, because I was thinking that people won't spend money online for a product which is cost $30, $40 or $50. This is, I believe, mindset of all the beginners, or maybe I was like that, but I know so many people who had the same mindset. So that's why I wasn't thinking even about the t-shirt, but I was creating a lot of organic sales by that t-shirt. And later on, when I jumped to mentor, I like was given big time, hard time from him, like, you have a winner in the store most probably, why you haven't tested? And I just decided to test, and boom, 8,000 in 15 days, something like that. It was just insane for me. So if you have some organic sales which were not advertised before and this kind of product still selling, try to test that out. But if that product has enough good margin, otherwise it would be difficult to be profitable. Okay. How many active stores do you personally have? So I have personally three stores with my main partner. One store is completely on hold. We have made more than 800,000 on it, if I'm not mistaken, 800,000 or 700,000 on it, and it is fashion store. Second store, it was as well fashion, but for a bit different way, and we have made $200,000 on that store. After that, we got fucked by Facebook. And we really had screwed time. We lost there $40,000 after made good profit. We lost all our profit because of the wrong employers. So this is another thing what we can discuss, that hire proper people. We really like, I'm teaching now people just because I went through all the steps for now on my level, where you can burn out yourself, where you can really got screwed, you can get hard times. So that's why I decided just to share my experience with my students, and this is helpful. When they have issues with PayPal, I'm giving them tips. When they issues with Stripe, I'm giving them tips. When they have issues with the store or with conversion, I'm telling them what to do. So this is exactly why mentorship is so important, why I'm doing that, because I wish someone on beginning of my way, when before I lost $4,000 to $6,000, I wish someone would come to me and do the same what I'm doing now to other people. Guide me what I should do and what I must to avoid. And if I have some issue, how to handle that issue. So this exactly, it's all about the experience. So my answer, three stores, two of them are not active right now. And one store, it's super active, multiple six figures in a month we are doing that with that store. And we are actually trying to build nice brand, niche brand. I would not say exact niche, but niche, in one niche, we are not going one product store no way. It is niche store and we are building our brand. Our goal for this year, multiple millions, because it's completely possible. With the proper product, with the branding of website, multiple like 2-3 million a year, it's completely possible. Actually, our goal, even it's a bit huge for now, but still I'm not level down my goals, never. 1 million a month, this is what we're trying to build in next year. 1 million a month store. So we are working on branding and focus on one store from our end and managing several stores for our clients. And I'm personally one-on-one mentoring other students from different countries to get their first results or scale their product if they have already winners.
Okay.
That makes sense. Thank you. No problem, dear. Hopefully it will be helpful for you. Can you save this live? Yeah, all my lives is gonna be uploaded to my YouTube channel. I just started, it's completely empty, there is a couple of videos only. So just follow me in YouTube and I'm there, Anatoly Labinsky. Just follow me there. I will be placing there all lives what I have, so if you miss, you can go there and watch it. Plus I'm now preparing some content about the Facebook ads, about Shopify settings, about the upsell apps and everything related to e-commerce. I'm gonna be placed there. And especially I love to speak about motivation, because without motivation you won't survive in e-commerce. If I won't be motivated enough by the proper listening people and listening audiobooks and reading proper books, I would not survive from the beginning, because all people were against me. All people were saying that I'm just chasing the dream, which is not possible to get. So that's why motivation is super important, and I will be speaking about motivation as well. So yeah, subscribe in my YouTube channel, and day by day, week by week, I'm gonna be adding there some value. For ads minimum a month, look, if you gonna be still testing, which is happens a lot, so you will need, as I was telling you, one product, $100 testing average. So if you're testing 10 products in a month, what is approximately going in a month like that, it's $1,000 a month. But if you get a winner inside of these 10 products, this winner gonna be paid by itself. This winner gonna be paid by itself and you will not invest any more your money. But you have to be ready with some extra amount, because Stripe have 10 days delay with withdrawing. So when you have, let's say, $300 from sales on the Stripe and you try to use that money, you cannot. For first 10 days it won't allow you. You can withdraw only in 10 days period of time. Later on, when they will trust you, they will give you 7 days, 5 days, and now we have every day withdrawal. So Stripe now giving us 1 day delay only in our store. But in the beginning, it's super hard to manage if most of the sales from Stripe, it's 10 days. And plus PayPal. PayPal is amazing because PayPal you connect to Facebook ads. And by PayPal, you can pay to supplier, you can pay to Facebook ads. And by that, you can manage your stuff. But if all the money in Stripe, it's gonna be difficult. You must have some extra amount with you, because all your income gonna be delayed for 10 days and you still need purchase the items, you still need pay for the ads. So be careful with that. That's why I'm telling you, you need have with you at least 1500 at least with you from the beginning to be able try it and be a bit saved, because really, like, you can make money from $300 or you can make money from $3,000. This is like real business. Here is no magical button or magical algorithm which is you press the button and you start making millions. No, step by step, system, testing, fail, give up, or don't give up, stand up, test again, fail, test again, fail, test again, winner, boom, and you start going, moving forward. But again, you got a winner and you don't know what to do with that, correct? For that, always you have to think about the mentor for the future. Just take the, I'm not speaking about myself, but there is a lot of good people in the e-commerce and different areas. You have to find for yourself a mentor who really gonna be telling you step-by-step process, not YouTube videos. YouTube video is gonna be saying to you, here is the testing, look, we got the sales, here is the results. But what about next step? What about in internal test settings? What conversion window to use? What kind of placement to use? How long to keep? What kind of ads? How many ads inside of ad set? CBO, ABO, nobody providing exact, like, complete picture. And this is the difference. When people watch on the different, 10 different YouTubers, they just gonna be, gonna lost because they will test it everything in the same time. And it's gonna be screwed up, the algorithm, and product will be burned out. Okay? You have to follow only one strategy. In the Facebook, there is thousands of strategies, but you have to choose one and follow it. How to increase my conversion rate? Okay, how many sales are you making a day, and do you have a winner on the store, first of all? Just answer. Tortoise, the only way of tortoise you can move forward is he must stick his neck out, take a risk to move forward. You just made so complicated message, but nice one. It was amazing. By the way, we have a call or no? Just confirm. After this live, do we have a call? Because we're supposed to have today. Bro, hopefully you have done home task. Because we discussed that Saturday, before I left, we must launch your first ads. Let me know, please. Answer yes or no. So, Timofeychuk Taras, can you tell me, do you have a winner? And what is your current sales? Explain to me, please, because after that I'll tell you how to increase the conversion rate. And should you think about that right now? This is the main point. If you're still testing, there is like another answer. Okay, Ross, I got you. Tomorrow I'll do my best because tomorrow I have a flight. I'm not sure if I will be able to jump on the call, but let's try it. Send me a message, please, what time you can, and we will discuss in the message, okay? I only just testing 2-3 sales a day with $35 a day on ads. So, you're getting sales, it's potential winner, I hope for that. I hope there is a good margin. Now conversion rate is 1.3. First of all, are you saying worldwide or you're selling for Big Four or United States? At work, it was if you can tomorrow. Yeah, Ross, just DM me, okay? We'll discuss that. Hey, next, big fan, thanks. So, okay, I don't wanna keep that long, it's already 40 plus minutes. Taras, look, if you have potential winner, first of all, focus on the what countries you are selling. If you are selling Big Four, e-packet countries, yeah, this is the answer. That's why it's 1.3. If you're selling worldwide e-packet countries, there is a lot of cheap countries, a lot of poor countries, which is still purchasing, but not that well. There is conversion rate completely different. And most of the big countries, which is in this year e-package targeting, taking the budget. So let's say Estonia. I don't remember if it's having e-package or no, but Estonia, let's say. Give you one sale, but it spent only 19 cents from $300 ad spend. Just because United States and Big Four, Big Eight countries are just taking all the budget on themselves. And it's not giving Estonia to purchase more because it's not spending there. But if you just launch to Estonia, it won't work. So, I mean, don't test different countries as for now. Separate countries, separate it. Don't do that as for now. So this is the answer. You are targeting e-package countries. There is supposed to be a low rate, but 1.3, I agree with you, it's a bit low. I can give you example. In our store, we're selling now mostly worldwide, mostly. And Brazil is doing amazing for us. We don't have fraud orders from there. If some people will say that there is fraud, Brazil, it's now potential market, it's huge. And we are getting 1 to 1.5 conversion rate. It's shit, because I love when I see in my store, when I see 3.5, 3.8, 4 plus, this is nice conversion rate. But when you're selling worldwide, or e-packet countries, you have to accept that, because here is nothing to do. Traffic is huge, but potential buyers is much lower quantity than if you push to United States only. So you can improve your conversion rate. First of all, you must make one change in a day. So if you change something on your landing page, you must wait 3 days and after that make another change, because we will analyze, or it increased conversion, or it decreased conversion, or it's the same. If it's decreased, you know what was the mistake and you return as before. If that change was increased, awesome, you'll keep it and you'll do another stuff to see if it will increase more. So first of all, change speed of your landing page. Maybe your speed is too low and people landing on the page and leaving, okay? If it's like that, so in this case, you must increase speed of your website, okay? Secondly, you have to play with the content and bullet points on your description. Work on the description of your product. Always try to change, put something on the top. On the top must be huge bullet point, why person supposed to think about purchase, why person supposed to buy from you. There is supposed to be bullet point about that, like main, what is the item and what problem is served, okay? And another thing, you have to change color of the add to cart button. The best in the market working yellow or green. Sometimes people say in black. I never had success with black button. And most of the people are really, I'm shocked. So many people coming to me, students, new students or new clients, and they have plain white add to cart button. It's insane. The plain add to cart button will have your conversion up to zero because people are not seeing. Like average user won't see the button add to cart if it's white. Believe me, I know what I'm saying. Change your color. Try to change your color. If it's green now, change to orange. If it's red now, change to green. If it's green, orange already has been tested, try black, try red. It depends on your design of your website. And see how that will go for you. Usually it's increased 0.3-0.35% to our conversion when we catch proper color on our add to cart button. Okay, change add to cart to buy it now. Buy it now usually working the best for us, instead of add to cart. And work with your checkout. Make your add to cart and checkout together. You can pay to editor to make it instead two steps, filling the form. You can make it in one step. It's gonna be in one landing page. It will increase your conversion a bit as well, because then more clicks people will do, then less conversion gonna be, and then more countries involved, then more conversion gonna be, or less conversion gonna be. Okay. I believe it was open answer. So I'm already long here. I'm already long on the live, so that's all, I believe. Next time, if you wish to have this kind of Q&A sessions weekly basis, let me know, DM me, and I will try to do my best to go and ask answer on all your questions, like in regular basis, okay? And in general, just looking forward to meet you again. And before I go, I want to tell you that as per demand from my audience, I was asking you if you would like to have a group coaching. And most of you said yes. So I decided to create group coaching, where in the Facebook group, gonna be people who will give me their ad account IDs. And I will go live 2 times a week. And I will tell them step by step what they supposed to do. And I won't show your product. I won't show your name of the campaigns, nothing. Only metrics. And I will be step by step telling you exactly what you have to do. And you'll implement what I'm telling you. You'll start getting results. And on the call, it's going to be a couple of people. So they're going to be studied from what I'm saying. And they won't see your product. Okay. And you're going to be studied from other people, mistakes, success, and all the things. So you're going to be analyzing together with me several ad accounts. And this is unbelievable experience to see 10, 20, 100 ad accounts a day It is unbelievable experience. That's why I know all these mistakes and issues, okay? One-on-one, I'm just telling everything. When I'm working one-on-one with person, I'm telling them everything what they have to do. Group coaching, it's where you can study together with other people in the same group and help each other. Help each other because it's kind of mastermind where you can find your future business partner. Where how I done, I found my main business partner in the mastermind groups. So you can find business partner, you can find great friends, and you can just cooperate and ask questions from more successful ad account owners. What should you do on this some particular stage? So group coaching gonna be launched in one week, and soon I will be just give them everyone option to join. With the beta testers, it's gonna be, I believe, only 10 people. Beta testers will get that with 50% discount. So just if someone interested, you must join in these first 10 people. Okay, take care. It was nice live. I hopefully that for some of you it was at least a couple of points was really helpful, and looking forward to speak to you more, and take care. Have a wonderful Saturday.